Falls, your next contest is scheduled for
Beefcake Charlie is yet another opponent selected by Deanna on Fire for Kellen Thomas for the RWA Hype Championship. And we discussed this a little bit last night, and since we have a moment here, I'll ask you this directly. You do not trust Deanna on Fire, and you think that there's a scheme there somewhere. Do you want to, you mentioned it yesterday, do you want to go into it a little bit more today, Bobby?
Day two.
Well, okay. Back in my days as a manager, I would constantly have to prove and show that I was an unbiased third party when deep down inside, my intentions were all in favor of my client. That's my stance. So when you have an intermediary who's setting up matches for you and scouting out talent, who's to say that she's not scouting talent that have significant deficiencies, ones that Kellen Thomas can exploit? Again, I said I think he's a babe in the woods because she's doing this without his knowledge.
That's true. He was here wrestling last month here at the Chop Shop, and she was away looking for talent. She was going cross-country looking for talent. She found two opponents for Kellen Thomas and put the title up on the line last night on him.
And, I mean, you want to talk about a lot of ground to cover. Last night's opponent was from Maine. This week's opponent, tonight's opponent, is from Daytona Beach, Florida. That's literally the northern and southern halves of the entire East Coast.
So you're not saying, and I know I asked this last night, I want to reiterate it again today, you're not saying that Kellen Thomas is a paper champion. These aren't people don't deserve a title shot. These are people that have something that Kellen can target, whether he knows it or not, to not garner an easy win, but almost to ensure victory to keep that title belt and the money rolling in for Deanna on Fire.
Absolutely, Rob. I mean, if you're a fighting champion and you want to defend your belt up against the best, are you going to sign up for a matchup against someone that you know can't hang?
No, absolutely not.
No, that's on you, and that's the same kind of person Kellen is. Who's to say Deanna is not working both angles? Who's to say that she's not finding opponents that have, I don't know, something that Kellen can exploit without really thinking about it? Kellen has always chopped down bigger trees. he's always been the smaller guy in a fight. He's not afraid of someone who has 50-some-odd pounds on him.
No, and we saw it last night. Prior to last night, he was a little bit hesitant about having Deanna in his corner. He called her out last night to join him and then had a celebratory hug after winning last night against Alexander Lee. He's bought all in almost. And you wonder if there is an ulterior motive as these fans in the sellout here at Legacy at the Chop Chop 2 cheer on Kellen Thomas against Beefcake Charlie.
You know, I got to say it. I mean, Beefcake, he's new to the RWA fold, but he really fits the mold, if you will. He's a guy who he walks to the beat of his own drum, and that's the crux of what RWA has always been. We've always been the type that's against the grain. We've always been the type to entertain the fans first, and we've always been the type to bark tradition. That's just what Beefcake's all about.
Kellen Thomas and Beefcake are having a cheer-off, and Beefcake, I think that's it. I don't think he can compete against the backflip. I could be wrong.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Here's where Kellen Thomas exceeds very well. He is a master manipulator. He manipulates time, space, the crowd, and he gets right into his opponent's head. Look, he's having a virtual pissing contest with Beefcake right now. In my opinion, Thomas has already won. On Fire knew that Beefcake was gonna exploit the 10 count. He's gonna worry about pandering to the fans before anything else. And here we are, we're almost 3 minutes into this matchup. What's
and he hasn't broken a sweat.
So right.
We're having the battle of the. We're having a cheer off.
That's right, folks. Entrances are not only for the beginning of the match.
And it looks like our referee is getting a decent hand.
Boo!
You really don't like her.
I don't trust her. She's a freaking manager.
Can't trust any of them.
No, of course you can't. Managers are no good.
You know, I was supposed to tell you something before the show, speaking to managers, but I think I'm going to wait. We got a match to call. There's something I got to get to, and I'll make sure I tell you
right.
At some point beforehand.
Well, you know, we're going to be here for the next 2 years, so that's fine. We got time.
Collar and elbow tie up by challenger and champion. Finally back to wrestling here. Kellen Thomas using the ropes for leverage, trying to break that collar and elbow as Beefcake Charlie in a side headlock, but has the strength advantage. And look at the strength of Beefcake Charlie, taking Kellen Thomas corner to corner.
Kellen Thomas is wrenching in that headlock. Beefcake may be relying on his brute strength, but he's running out of oxygen quick.
And there's really not much to be had here in the Chop Shop with all the heat and humidity. Kellen Thomas really working that headlock. Beefcake Charlie has gone post to post with Kellen Thomas. And now, Kellen Thomas finally using that headlock and has gotten Beefcake almost down to a knee.
Look at this now. Beefcake whipping Kellen Thomas off the ropes, who runs into a flesh wall, also known as Hot Stuff Challenge.
Kellen Thomas is going to try that shoulder block again. Off the ropes goes Kellen. And big shoulder tackle. And, well, that hurt Kellen more than it hurt Beefcake.
Aaron, me to watch. I mean, the definition of insanity is trying the same thing multiple times and expecting different results. And we're watching Kellen Thomas slowly slip down the annals of insanity here.
I don't think this is going to work out for Kellen. Off the ropes goes Beefcake after the challenge. And Beefcake is still running the ropes. And Kellen's waiting for that shoulder tackle. And there it is, and well, the champion is not in a good way right now.
Shades of Shawn Michaels WrestleMania 25 as he flounders outside of the ring. That brute force strength of Beefcake clearly on display.
It is. Speaking of Shawn Michaels, it's July 1st as we are here for Legacy 11 here. It's also Canada Day. Just to remind all of you friends up north, Brett screwed Brett. Happy Canada Day.
It's terrible.
I know. Kellen Thomas with a switch. Rear waist lock now. Beefcake Charlie. And Kellen Thomas is really trying to use his strength. Usually he's not the one that's out-muscled in a match.
And Beefcake reapplies the waist lock into a chest lock.
So to speak. That could get you 3 to 5 depending on where you are.
Are you kidding me? They sent me away to Virginia for a couple of years for that same shit. I felt up a couple rats and I was sent down south to exile. How does this guy get away with it?
I have no comment.
You remember those couple of years I wasn't allowed around?
I do remember those couple of years. Kellen Thomas is trying for a drop toe hold. And the drop part, he's got the toe hold in, but the drop part wasn't working. Kellen Thomas charges. Backsplash off the corner goes Thomas, the champion, back in with another backsplash. And Beefcake is reeling in the corner. The champion trying to rev up the crowd behind him, get everything behind it, and there's a third. Beefcake Charlie Snapmare down. Lateral press, cover 1, 2, and Kellen Thomas thrown off. Kellen Thomas, the champion in control. Irish whip, reversed by Beefcake Charlie. Off the ropes goes the champion. Tackled big time, sent to the canvas.
Beefcake Charlie weighing just under 300 pounds. He's really muscling over Kellen Thomas. It's starting to wear in. I think all that running around early on in this matchup has amounted to some fatigue. And Beefcake Charlie, blindly runs into that top turnbuckle.
Shoulder tackle, nobody home. Kellen Thomas with that elbow hits the mark. Now can he get a cover? 1, 2, and no hook of the leg there, only garnered a 2 count. We have not seen Kellen Thomas this nonchalant, if you will, in a match for a while.
Sure, I mean, hell, he went to war last night.
He did, that's true. I mean, he did wrestle last night. Beefcake Charlie, from what I've been told, did not work last night. But he is the fresh man. Kellen Thomas cannot get Beefcake up on his shoulders. Charging, ducking the line is Beefcake. Big tackle again takes Kellen Thomas down. Off the ropes, another tackle. Kellen Thomas is in a bad way. The champion is in trouble. Irish rep into the corner. Beefcake charges, nobody home. He was able to block it. Off the ropes was Kellen Thomas, and another tackle takes down Kellen Thomas.
I have not seen Riot Man ever ping pong like this, ever. I've seen him in a bad way. I've seen him up against dudes that are twice his size before, but never has he been knocked around like a pinball in between the ropes. Whoa, what do you mean stop? Referee!
Dana on fire has convinced Beefcake Charlie to not assault her client.
What the hell's she doing on the apron? What did I tell you, Rob? What did I tell you?
As a former manager, you know how these things work.
And every time I did that, I knew I was baking the ropes.
Oh, no. I think Deanna, she wants to get involved, is in the ring now, and this could end poorly for her. Beefcake Charlie's going to assault the woman, and
he's from Daytona Beach. It's not his first time.
Is he? I don't even know how to call this. Hashtag me too.
What in the world?
Deanna on fire.
What?
Ducks Beefcake. What the? Oh my God.
He's got her in the booby trap.
But he doesn't see behind him that Kellen Thomas has perched himself on the second turnbuckle. Deanna on fire's face has been assaulted with all sorts of spetsum and jetsum.
That's one way to put it.
Thomas!
Uh-oh. Oh, he got caught in that crossbody attempt, Rob.
Beefcake Charlie is the champion. And now is he? He's calling. He's going to climb up to the top rope as Deanna on fire has cleaned up the sputum and spetsum and jetsum. She's angry. She is, in fact, dare I say, on fire.
Oh!
Second rope, nobody home, no water in the pool.
That's a lot of beef.
Kellen Thomas is trying to capitalize. He's trying to get up to a vertical base. He does. Thomas has Beefcake up. Good God, oh,
Steelmatic!
Cover, two, and three. The champion retains. Kellen Thomas retains. The Riot Man comes out victorious. 2 days in a row, two defenses, an arm draped around his manager, Deanna on fire. What could this relationship turn into?
It might turn into dollar signs, even if it lacks every bit of common sense, Rob. This has been a winning formula for both Kellen Thomas and Deanna on fire. She's produced results. I don't know. Something doesn't smell right. And I'm not talking about her hygiene. I'm talking about the complexion of these matchups here. These two played dog and pony for over 5 minutes before getting into the action, Rob. Come on!
And she knew that he was going to do it.
Bet your ass she did. Well, Beefcake makes his RWA debut at the 11th annual Legacy event.
And he is victorious.
He won back his fanny pack.
Yeah, that's what it seems like.
He's a winner.
And you know what? She convinced him that he won.
She is both a soothsayer and a booking agent, ladies and gentlemen. How things are going to develop, there's only one way to know.
That is the third title match. That is the third champion to retain. What does this mean if you're the Middlesex Express going into tonight and Chris Cruz? Every champion has retained thus far. That's not a format that always holds true.
These guys have everything to fight for, and they're not going to let some outsider just come in and take what's rightfully theirs. That is what's been on display for the past 2 days at Legacy. #NeverSayDie. We'll see you up soon, folks. We got another match to give you.